In today's tutorial, we'll take a quick look at how we can run a 3D inspection between a point cloud and a 3D model. If you haven't already watched our cloud-to-cloud inspection tutorial, be sure to check it out first, as we give a more in-depth tour of the 3D inspections tool available in RealWorks. I have a folder containing all my IFC elements, and we can go ahead and toggle that on. We have a number of elements already modeled, including the lighting, pipes, and air ducts. We just want to isolate the columns for now. Let's first start by identifying what we want to compare. We'll rest our mouse over one of these columns to get the layer name. As we can see, they're all titled IFC column. Head over to the Home tab and choose Find. Type in the name of the object you're searching for. We'll select all the elements, right-click them, and choose View Only This. For the basis of this tutorial, we're just going to work with the first two sections of columns. Let's see which numbers correspond to the ones we don't need. It looks like 1, 3, and 7. Let's select all our layers again, and while holding down the Control key, we can click on the ones that we don't need. Once you have what you need selected, go to the Inspections tab and choose Merge Meshes. We'll find our newly created object and just drag it out of its folder. This will combine our selection into one object. It also retains the original models. We can also give it a name to help differentiate it. Let's turn the cloud back on and toggle the See Inside filter so we can see what's going on. Now that we have our models, we can open up the 3D Inspections tool. Select both the IFC layer and the cloud, then head to the Inspections tab and open the tool. We can see our reference is highlighted in red and our comparison in green. Again, for an in-depth discussion on the tool itself, check out our cloud-to-cloud inspection tutorial. Let's clean up the cloud and isolate the area that we're working with. This will eliminate unnecessary points and help free up your system resources. Open the segmentation tool and switch on the 3D objects. We'll draw a box around the area that we want to keep and choose Keep In. Now we can see that highlighted in green. We're also going to downsample our cloud. Choose the sampling tool. For this, we will use spatial sampling. A distance of half an inch will work for us. For 3D inspections, it is not necessary to retain the full cloud density. We can get a great inspection with a less dense cloud, and that will also free up a lot of system resources, allowing the tool to run faster. That's decreased our cloud from over 17 million points to about a million. We'll set our max distance to 4 inches and hit Compute. Again, for a detailed explanation of all these options, check out our cloud-to-cloud comparison tutorial. RealWorks has generated the comparison between the two surfaces. Let's go ahead and select Absolute Distances, which will change our scale to start from 0. We can see a color map has been generated on the cloud, along with a legend for the distances. Let's switch on our 3D layer. We'll highlight over an area, then hold down the N key to get a magnified view of the comparison. Another nifty tool is the filtering options. Since we have all this extra information, we can use the filter to simply cut out the remaining point cloud and keep only the comparison areas. This is a very useful tool as it saves you time having to clean up the point cloud. It will also provide a more clean deliverable if you choose to later export this cloud. Once we're happy with everything, we can hit Create and a new 3D inspection layer will be created. Let's go ahead and rename this. Let's toggle on our 3D inspection layer. Since we filtered it, we can easily see just the part of the cloud pertaining to our inspection. By switching to cloud color, we can see the inspection map generated. Our original point cloud and IFC models all stay intact. Head over to the 3D Inspection Analyzer to view the legend and for more filtering options. And just like that, we've completed our comparison. We can see what areas of these columns may be deviating from the models, as shown in the changes in color. If you have any questions regarding this tutorial, or suggestions for future tutorials or improvements, please drop them in the comments below. And as always, be sure to follow along for more RealWorks tips.